Ovid, and this is part two of the All-Stars playthrough. So, I wonder how much further until things start to properly change. Okay, so Aura of Fortitude appears to have been nerfed slightly, but Overpower got buffed. Also, I've now seen some of what the Ronin does because Drip Missouri posted a screenshot of some recent changes that strange how Drip Missouri always says that Ultimus is overpowered, yet the support ability of this looks absolutely insane. Like, it says makes target immune to damage until the spell or 8,000 damage has been dealt to it. So, this is basically a non-permanent version of the Icebird support ability from Ultimate, but I don't think the Icebirds absorb that much damage. I think they absorbed like 5,000 when I was testing them, if I remember correctly, yeah. I don't know, I haven't really made any battle-related changes in a while, and when I test, I always bring in the iconic trio of Lost Helmet, Angelic Rainbird, and Undead Healer. Some of you are probably wondering why I decided to make the Icebird's effect permanent, and so some of you are probably wondering why I decided to make the Icebird's effect permanent, and the reason for that is because around the time I was developing the Icebird's class, I had recently started playing Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, and it's kind of similar to Angry Birds Epic, but at the same time, it's definitely more advanced. There are some abilities that I don't think would be possible to recreate accurately in Angry Birds Epic, or abilities that hadn't been done before in Angry Birds Epic. An example of this is the Armor Shred effect is an effect that cannot be dispelled and lasts permanently for the entire battle. And originally I was going to make the Permafrost shield have the cannot be dispelled part, but turns out whether or not something can be dispelled is hard-coded into the skill template, so I went with the permanent option instead. And also, in case you're wondering more about the original Armor Shred effect, then that effect actually stacks. And there are multiple characters that can buy it. And what the effect does is it basically lowers the target's defense by 50%. I should probably adapt my strategies to the balance changes that Drip Missouri made, rather than just doing what I was doing in unmodded in Raybirds Epic. As in this mod, Knight is objectively better for once. Wait, that was a different support ability. So, Lightning Bird isn't full-on mandatory in this fight anymore. Ha ha ha! Okay, that was a lot less damage than I thought it was going to be. Like, I've just played so much pork side that I'm used to brutes just absolutely one-shotting. And I mean, I guess it was like that in the Prince Porky Only series as well. So, Drip Missouri probably enough. Right, I've got a better idea. Oh, wait. Red's attack only affects one. Forgot about that. It's just been so long since I properly played the game with the normal birds. So, from the start. Thank you. Okay. I'm guessing the lost equipment that was shown in the trailer must also be in the caves, right? Because just without the 3.0.1 decomp, then we can't change the map in any way. So the Chronicle Caves has just become the kind of place where you're adding something new, place everything here! Hopefully, the decomp will be made for 3.0.1 soon. But at the same time, it's become a bit of a joke throughout the community that the decomp is being postponed solely because of one person. I have no clue how a decomp is made. But if it takes too much longer to get the 3.0.1 decomp, then I might just take a look at the 2.0.0 decomp and just see if I can do that, but 3.0.1. Because, like, Ultimate needs a PC port. And so does All-Stars. Like, at the moment in terms of mods, then Porkside is just the most technologically advanced mod in existence. Like, right now, Porkside is the only mod available for download that has a PC port. It's because of the decomp. Because it uses an older version. Well, I mean, I guess the friend expansion and mod exists as well, but I kind of forgot that exists because when you think of Coldest Tea, you think of Porkside. Well, you heard the announcement. Go do it. I'll include them in the end screen. Or at least I hope I'll remember to include him in the end screen. Just for good measure, I'll add him to the part one end screen right now. There's still around an hour left until it premieres. Okay, done. Ha-ha! I think with that Facebook pop-up, I'm going to do something similar with my own mod, but I don't think I'm going to advertise my own YouTube. Like, I am going to change the pop-up, but it's not going to be the same thing as what All Stars did, because I don't actually like having a large audience.
Bye.
Okay, looks like that's gonna do it for this video. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!